Question I have is, most of the people think by studying a lot of hours they will get better, you know, if they put a lot of hours. Does that work? Does it matter, like, what hours they put in?
Not at all. It's better to practice 5 minutes right than 5 years wrong. If I try to do the wrong thing, it's even worse, actually, the more hours you put. Suppose you play, want to improve pickup, and then you have the wrong posture. And now I practice 5 hours a day that for 10 years. Good luck. Because you, at some point you have to start thinking, well, actually I'm not good in pickup. I guess someone told me this before and I should pay attention. Actually I'm not talented or something. No, it's not that. But you never tried the right way and you never questioned, am I playing it right?
But the oversight is so important for that to be checked. Because how would you know if you're doing wrong?
This is one point which is this is the main thing, is to verify what I am doing. Otherwise, the amount of time it will work against your progress. So you play more time. And you don't even know if it's right. That's why, in Skype, we do this coaching program, and I have recorded the homeworks. You know, the homeworks are recorded in unlisted videos, which says, don't send me, and then we give feedback, like, this thing here, you can improve in this and that, and then we talk about the material, and they also have a data, like, this is, in February, I was playing this much. That's what I did, 100 beats per minute. In March, in April, look what I did, then here I get the stock, at some point I get the stock. Why? Then if you are getting a stock in something you don't know, you ask. The other day in the conservatory, one guy came and I asked him, he said, well, I think I am getting a stock in pickup and that. I said, okay, at what speed are you playing? Were you playing last year and how speed are you playing now? And he said, well, I did never write this down, I don't know. So, if people don't know, first of all, because first the teachers, they try to do away with it. Because there is one thing, which is true. If I want to make you as a student, if I want to try to make your life easy, my life becomes difficult. I make your life easier by making my life difficult. Because if I am hired in a bureaucratic institution to teach, and it only matter thing is that this is lesson classes. This is from 1 to 3 p.m. And then I have to fulfill that time. Given anything, I don't care what you will do. Now, if I have to actually care, then I have to put the effort to check, verify, check the guy. Let's see how he plays. Mm-hmm. Help him. What are you doing? Maybe he's doing something wrong. It's most of the time the fault is the teacher's fault. Mm-hmm. The student is not in fault. So the student wants to play better. That's why he's there. He's there because he wants to be playing better. But they get never help because in these bureaucratic environments they don't care. Mm-hmm. Actually, and I prefer to. I do know in this channel how many videos we record. 2,500. Of course, this is difficult to do.
Absolutely.
But I do it. I do it to make your life easier. Because if you can practice with me at any time, just put the video and practice, do the strumming or anything with me directly at any time, you can do it. But I have to sit there and record it first.
Right.
So my life became difficult and now your life become easier. It would be easier if I tell you, don't worry. You don't need more speed. Like other guy came and said, the teacher said that I am okay, but I feel I am not getting good really in the skill plane. I said, we just go and tell him, you know what, I feel stuck, give me all the materials. And he said, yeah, I did it, but they say, he said, you are okay like this, but that is enough. Why? Because then that way he gets away. People is not interested. Actually, those are, most of the teachers out there are people who teach because they couldn't do other thing. I said this in the workshop today. Do you think I could not be performer with the level of playing I have? Of course I can be performer, but I never wanted, because this is not for me. For me, the real value is to create, you know, make others play, to create this kind of residual earning when I see how others play. This gives me more pleasure than if people see me how I play when they're then rather than let's go to the next place, and you keep eating rotten pizza anywhere, and then again an airport again. I did when I was young for a while, and I trained performance.
Yes.
But this is not for me.
Well, I feel really lucky as one of the students that you do feel like that, because that gives us an advantage that we could use the classes and have that sort of level of knowledge be told to us. So thank you that you feel like that about it.
Thanks to you, Ali.
It's a sincere thing I'm saying.
You see what is the effort there.
Yeah, you go the beyond.
The student has to put an effort. Otherwise, don't be teacher if you're not willing to do that. My duty here is how to make you play better. Not if I ate or not, or I am tired, I want to go home. My duty is how I help him. And then if you do that, everyone will love it. And very few will hate you, actually, also. Because people who have been years in institutions learning and don't advance one centimeter, but they come here 3 months in the program, being in Skype, they're learning, and they say, oh, wow, now I'm really advancing. Of course they will leave the other fellows, because they realize that this guy never care about if I am learning really or not. So the most important thing is to assist the others wholeheartedly and try to improve their playing. And when you do that, you are really teaching. Otherwise it's cheating only. Mm-hmm. Teaching, cheating, some similar. But it's not. The difference is you have to put the effort there.
La improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando, de cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Muy bien. Pablo. Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene esas, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.